Hi, in this video I will explain with two freestyles how to judge the difficulty of a single rope routine. First it's a girl and then later on we're gonna do a boy, and I will explain you for every skill which level it is and why it is that level. AS backwards was one of the exceptions of the crosses. It's a level 3 and not a level 2, because 90% of the crosses was a level 2, but this is an exception. AS and CL and TS backwards is a level 3. A level 3 backwards, a toad in double under. She managed to do the toad while she was in the air. A pretty easy level 3. A TJ triple under, level 4. Here, a very cool move, definitely for the creativity of the freestyle, but for difficulty it's worth nothing, because the rope doesn't go under the body, it doesn't make a full revolution. So nothing. TS backwards, also level 3, same principle as AS backwards. A triple under side fin cross cross without switching of the arms, so basically it's just a level 3, two levels for the triple and one level because she managed to do a crisscross in it, so level 3. Kruger Kruger, level 2, level 4, same as AS, AS, CL, CL, and so on and so on. Here she does a lot of triple unders. The first one was side swing cross cross, so that's a level 3, the easy triple under. Then she did something with the completion of an EB, that's a level 4, it's the same category as a TJ triple. And then she did something with a hand here and a hand there, also same principle, completion of a level 2 skill while she was in the air, so that was also a level 4 skill. Going to a frog, nothing, because your rope doesn't go under your body. Coming out of the frog is a level 2. Now she does crisscross into a push-up. So the rope goes under her, crisscross into a push-up. Going into a power skill, you only get credit if your rope went under you before you hit the floor. That's what she did, because she managed to do a crisscross before. So she definitely gets two levels, and she gets an extra level because she does the cross. So this is a level 3. Coming out of a push-up, level 2. Some difficult doubles, so that was a level 2 and a level 3. A triple under TS was a level 4. Going to a one-handed frog, nothing. Coming out of a one-handed frog, a level 3, not a level 2. Coming out of an ordinary frog is level 2. Coming out of a one-handed frog is level 3. Double under TS, double under AS, level 3. Principle of the difficult doubles are level 3. This one. She doesn't jump the rope, so nothing. Jumping out of the caboose was of the same level as jumping out of a T-toad, inverse T-toad, it's a level 3. This was a quadruple with full completion of a level 2, because she did the AS while she was in the air, so that's a level 5. That was a level 2 release, the easiest release, and then a level 4 for a triple under, which is in the category of the TJs, 1, 2, 3. Then another quadruple where she managed to do a level 2 while she was in the air, so once again a level 5. Reps, it's nothing for difficulty. And then another two level 4 skills, triple unders with completion of a level 2. And in the last one it was even landing in a level 3 skill. So landing in a level 3 skill, a triple under landing in a level 3 skill is also a level 4. So don't forget that also these special skills is a level 3 and this special skill is a level 3. So the last one that she just did was triple under landing in a level 3 skill. Same as 1, 2, 3, where you also land in a level 3 skill and you did a triple under landing in a level 3 skill, which is in total a level 4 skill. Same category. A difficult double, which was a level 3, then another level 4, a difficult triple under. another level 4, this is just a level 1. A more difficult gymnastic skill, level 3. Another level 4, it's the triple under landing in the level 3 skill. 2, 4, same category, and another 4. And if that was a quadruple, it was a level 4, it was only a triple, it was a level 3. CL backwards is level 3. You remember that CL would be level 3, level 5, but she didn't get over it, so she made a mistake, she will not get the level 5. A release where she catches a handle and the handle made a full revolution, that's the level 3. She didn't jump over the rope while she caught the handle and was still in the air, so it's only a level 3. And then some more level 3s, and this one is a level 4, again a triple under like the DJ. And then the end of the routine. Next routine. So, 3 triple unders, and all of them contain level 2 skills while he was in the air, so that's already 3 times a level 4. In the last one, he even landed in a level 2 skill, but you don't get extra credit for it, so they all stay a level 4. One-handed frog into a CL, level 4. Double under push-up, level 3, coming out of the push-up with an AS, level 3. 2 triples with again full completion of a level 2, so that was 4, level 4 and another level 4, and then the last one was even a quadruple with a full completion of a level 2, so that's even a level 5. CLCL forwards, level 2, level 4, backwards it would have been 3, 5. Double under landing in a level 3 is still a level 3 skill. Full completion of a level 3, because CL backwards is a level 3, and he did it in a double, this makes it a level 4. For the round off, he doesn't get anything because the rope doesn't go under his feet. Double under to a power, it's level 3. Doesn't matter whether it's a split or a push-up. Split to a CL, same as push-up to a CL, frog to a CL, level 3. The first one was a quadruple with full completion of a level 2, so that's a level 5 again. And then the second one was a very special thing, it was what he called a triple under T-toad. He did 1, 2, 3. And you remember that coming out of a T-toad is a level 3, so basically he did a triple under, and while he was in the air he managed to do a level 3. So that is in total a level 5. That's the same category as 1, 2, 3. Full completion of a level 3 skill while you're in the air, if you do that in a triple under, you get a level 5. Coming out of a T-toad, level 3. Side swing, TS, so a triple under, a landing in a level 3, it's another level 4. After that he did side swing TS, same category, level 4, but then he did side swing TS open, and that is a level 5, because while he was in the air he completely did the TS. Nothing for difficulty. Level 3, just side cross. 3 times the same category, a double under, landing in a level 3. A TS, then a CL, and then an AS, so that's all level 3. This is a front flip, he didn't use his arm, so that's definitely already a level 4. He managed to do a triple under, so that made it into a level 5. Frog to CL, level 3, CL to push-up, level 4. Push-up to CL, level 3, but I think he already did that. So if you remember this as a judge that he already did it, you shouldn't write down the last level 3. A triple under into a split is a level 4. A triple under is 2 levels, and going into a power skill is 2 extra levels, so that's a level 4. from a split to an AS level 3. Level 3, not an easy gymnastic, not a really hard gymnastic, something in between. TS backwards, level 3. He caught the rope, but he didn't jump over it, so basically it's also just a level 3. It's not the easiest release, because he didn't just catch a rope, he caught the rope after it made a full revolution, but he didn't jump the rope or anything, so it's just a level 3. Level 4, all of the same category as the TJ triple under. And the last one that he did was an EK twist, which is a level 3. Side swing backwards, forwards. Voila. I think I can show you another 10 freestyles, but you will see that it's always the same. You probably have some questions on specific skills. Don't hesitate to write me an email, maybe videotape it first and then send it through the email, and then I can tell you which level this skill is and maybe also why.